In my hometown, I mourned the widow's lawns and helped my father with the colt in the barn on Sunday morn. And then the army came and they called me up. The letter said, be at the docks by 6 o'clock sharp. Dad didn't know how to tell you, only knew how hard that'd be. Less than 1 year beneath our belt, still you meant the world to me. You shouldered me, and you took my hand, said that you would be here waiting, and no matter how far along I went, and when I returned, we'd build a house by the water. We would take long walks in our old age with our many sons and daughters. So I took that wish and put it in my backpack and kissed you on the lips. I said, don't worry, I'll be back. And then I turned away. I could not turn away my tears. I didn't know if when I'd see you next would be months or would be years. Were filled with guys like me who had not reached 21. And though the rain was bad, we took solace in our fleet, happy to have cigarettes and food enough to eat. And then the orders came that tomorrow we would fight. And if some of you have loves at home, then now's the time to write. So I grabbed my pen and my writing book, but no words would fall upon the page, no matter how hard I shook. So I took my shank and cut off a piece of hair and imagined you receiving it, sitting in your rocking chair. See my home, and the band was waiting on the pier, and the half-mast flags were flown. I wheeled myself from my hospital room, trying to accept what kind of life I would resume. And then I saw you there, and you met my eyes, and nothing could prepare for such a terrible surprise. For in your arms was a blue-eyed child. And after all the cannons I had faced, this was my greatest trial. The colts in the barn on Sunday morning.